America is developing an incredible aircraft of the future, and that's exactly what I want to tell you about. Today, you'll learn about the fastest plane in the world, proudly named the Lockheed SR Route 72, Darkstar. We'll talk about its creation, technical specifications, and of course, the records it aims to break. I promise, it will be interesting. The elusive legend of the past. But before we dive into the development of the best plane on the planet, I'd like to tell you about its predecessor. What do you think is the best military aircraft? Many will name a model of one fighter jet or another from different countries. And I'll say that the best military aircraft is the one that no one can ever intercept. And there's at least one like that. Meet the Lockheed SR Route 71. This is currently the fastest plane in the world. And what's most remarkable is that it was created way back in 1964. 1964 year. Year. Doesn't sound very cool yet, does it? What if I told you that this piece of metal could accelerate to what speed? 3.5 Mach. If you don't know what that is, here's a little reference for you. 1 Mach is equal to the speed of sound. Yes, yes, you heard that right. This plane was 3.5 times faster than the speed of sound. But that's far from all. So, what was interesting about this plane? But let's take it one step at a time. As you can imagine, creating a plane like this was no easy feat. The scientists of that time achieved the literally impossible. And all of this was thanks to the Cold War and the huge budgets for research. Something new. That's how science progressed. With weapons and all the horrors that come with them. And here, I'd like to dive into history. The thing is, during those years, there was a Cold War going on between the USA and the USSR. On top of that, there were quite a few other local conflicts. For example, in Vietnam, North Korea, as well as in Syria, Egypt, and Jordan. And everywhere, America tried to use this plane for its intended purpose. Back then, there was no weapon that could intercept the SR Route 71. But also the weaponry. It can't be pulled off by itself. It was a reconnaissance aircraft that took aerial photos of the terrain and enemy forces. And this is exactly where it was used, just in time. Cold War between the USA and the USSR. But here, I'd like to pause on the Cold War between the USA and the USSR. After all, this is probably the most interesting conflict in terms of using this amazing plane. In general, if you've read history textbooks, you probably know that the USSR used Cuba to place its nuclear warheads. This was necessary for the strategic deterrence of America. That was too far from Eurasia to launch a direct missile strike from the territory of the Soviet Union itself. And of course, there was quite a bit of other weaponry on the island of Cuba. For example, advanced air defense systems and the best interceptor planes at that time, the MiG-25. And how surprised the Soviets were when a reconnaissance aircraft was calmly flying over their territory at absolutely unreachable speeds. Just so you understand, it's not that the interceptors couldn't catch up, it's this monster. But the air defense systems were powerless. And I want to point out the fact that missiles for intercepting planes and other missiles travel along the most optimal trajectory. And at a very high speed. But apparently, not as high as would be necessary to intercept the 71st. In general, throughout its entire operational time, which is about 30 years, not a single 71 was shot down or destroyed by the enemy. All combat missions were completely successful. But how did the Americans manage to achieve such high effectiveness? Let me tell you. It all comes down to many really cool engineering solutions that were under the hood of this reconnaissance aircraft. The thing is, it had a very special engine. Its uniqueness lay in the fact that at subsonic speeds below Mach 1 it operated like a standard turbojet engine. But when the speed exceeded a certain threshold, it turned into a straight-through one. In addition, at speed, it had a movable cone on its engine nacelles, which was also retracted at high speeds to achieve maximum performance. It was precisely because of this that they were able to achieve such high speeds. Secret technologies of the past. But the SR Route 71 wasn't just rich in speed. Its advantage also lay in a special stealth technology. What is that? It's a special coating, a paint based on ferrite. It allows for the absorption of radio waves that are used in radar and guidance systems for both air defense and regular missiles. In addition to that, cesium was added to the fuel. No, not to carry out gas attacks on the enemy. it made it possible to reduce thermal emissions from engines. Thus, it would have been even more difficult for missiles with infrared sensors to intercept this plane. All these technologies together allowed the 71st to remain undetected. This paint is especially amazing, because thanks to it, the huge body of the reconnaissance aircraft was properly cooled. And that's really important when your plane is reaching such high speeds. The regular friction with the air that we don't even notice can literally burn anything up. You don't have to look far. Just take a look at the meteors that fall to our planet. They all burn up completely, even when they're huge chunks. So, what are the technical specifications of this aircraft? And here things get really interesting. Its so-called ceiling, the maximum altitude at which this reconnaissance aircraft can comfortably fly, is 16 miles. And the range on a single tank is a whopping 3,000 miles. And all of this at a speed of 3 Mach. Impressive, isn't it? But there's one catch. This plane consumed way too much fuel. So much that even your car wouldn't use that much in a year, while the State Route 71 is out there on a reconnaissance mission, racing through the sky at afterburner. In short, it was really expensive. Well, the size of this reconnaissance aircraft was impressive. Length over 100 feet, wingspan 50. And this carcass weighed more than 70 tons. In general, this is not a small plane at all, which is as difficult to catch as a mosquito. It's such a huge machine, it's strange how it didn't fall. Fortunately, there were almost no accidents with these amazing machines. And that's a really scary event, even on a regular road, especially in the U.S. You got into a car accident in America and don't know what to do next. Where do you go for help? Where can you find a good lawyer? How to get compensation if you don't have insurance? The accident company. America helped secure $21 million in compensation for its clients. Here, you'll definitely get answers to all your questions. Link in the description. The heir of the Emperor. All right, I see you're already a bit tired of the story about this ancient aircraft. But I couldn't help but talk about it. The State Route 72, which we're going to discuss today, has become a direct heir and continuation of the legend.
But there's one but.
This aircraft doesn't exist yet. Actually, it's more likely that it already exists. It's just that we won't be able to see it because it's on a military base. With the strictest restrictions. What's the essence of the State Route 72 project? It's about breaking the existing speed records. And no, not by a couple of tenths of a Mach, but almost by a factor of two. The thing is, Lockheed is aiming for a full 6 Mach. I'm just in shock because humanity is barely. How it surpasses the speed of sound. It's so fast that you could fly half of Eurasia in just an hour. I'll tell you more. If this machine can fly like this for about 6 hours, then in that time it will do. A complete trip around our planet. Now it's clear how fast it is, and naturally, this plane will have the best of everything. Stealth technology is a must-have for it. It has proven itself so well by allowing for serious cooling of the surfaces, which is absolutely necessary for use in this aircraft. As for what kind of fuel it will use, unfortunately, no one can say for sure. It might be something new, some kind of development that will allow for insane power outputs. Or maybe everything will be exactly the same, just like in the good old 71. We'll find out about this really soon. Why do I think that? The thing is, smaller prototypes, and accordingly, with worse characteristics, have already taken to the skies. Modernization of the aircraft. Many might think that since this is a direct continuation of the legendary State Route 71, there won't be many differences. But in reality, it's far from that. The engine has a fairly similar operating scheme. At low speeds, it works like a regular turbojet, but at high speeds, it switches to another mode. That's exactly what allows it to achieve such high power and speed. How exactly this will be implemented is still unknown. But personally, I think they'll use previous developments to create it. You can't let good things go to waste. And here's another fact that aviation enthusiasts at Lockheed are debating. The SR-72 could turn out to be completely unmanned. Yes, yes, you heard that right. But why? It's all about the safety of people and their physiological capabilities. Unfortunately, our bodies are imperfect. In many cases, it can become injured even though you did absolutely nothing to cause it. and the 72 ND's too rapid acceleration fits this definition. Now, imagine yourself in the pilot's seat. You're racing at a huge altitude. You're wrapped in the rigid pilot seat, and through the glass, you can barely make out anything because the speed is just insane. So, besides that, your plane warms up just fine. I wouldn't want to be in this tin can without air conditioning, and there might not be any. In pursuit of speed, engineers will do everything to reduce weight and improve the flight characteristics of the glider. And the split system will take up space, and it weighs quite a lot. So, think about why they might make it a man. Although no one is ruling out the possibility of creating a manned version. Still, wireless communication, while good, can be harmful at such speeds. Even the slightest delay of a couple of milliseconds can lead to the destruction of the plane. This isn't just a couple million dollars. The project has reportedly cost several billion, according to various opinions, and some experts claim that the development will cost $1 trillion. Do you believe those numbers? A next level, fighter jet. Well, I've saved the most interesting part for last. The thing is, these days the military has had special satellites for a long time that can take any photo with incredible accuracy. Just go to Google Maps and you can find your house there, the car, and the office. What can we say about the military telescopes that are in space right now? They can photograph everything with such precision that you can even see a car wheel. So why, in the age of such technologies, make a reconnaissance aircraft that can still be shot down? Air defense systems aren't standing still and have long been able to intercept really fast objects. This is exactly the conclusion the creators came to, and they stated that the State Route 72 will likely be able to carry on board weapons. What kind of missiles will those be? No one can say for sure. But I found an article that talked about precision weapons. Just imagine how effective this plane could be. Achieve the target in an instant, strike almost unnoticed, and leave a potentially dangerous area at the same high speed. This is just the best fighter jet of our time. And if this plane can carry even a small nuclear payload, then all its opponents are definitely in for it. Why, Darkstar? By the way, you probably noticed that there are a lot. In which articles is the State Route 72 referred to as Darkstar? What am I talking about? It's even in the title of my video. But where does this nickname come from? After all, Lockheed hasn't named this plane yet. It's all about the fan base. Recently, a movie came out called Top Gun Maverick. It shows a fictional aircraft that is based on the 72nd. And it's actually called Darkstar. Apparently, Lockheed Martin fans liked the movie so much that they decided to link the name of the fictional plane to the real one. But personally, I'm not a big fan of that name. It seems like they could come up with something much more formidable and interesting. Take, for example, the name of a Soviet bomber, the Tu-160. They gave it the nickname White Swan. I mean, it sounds incredible, powerful, and cool. Personally, I think that name really suits it. It really suits it, since it has quite recognizable light contours. Yeah, and just seeing it gives you chills. It's like you saw an incredibly beautiful swan. And this plane. It's also a kind of legend. After all, it's the fastest bomber in the world. And not only that, it's also the heaviest. Overall, it's an amazing machine, so if you want, I'll make a video about it too. Interesting facts and rumors. Well, I guess it's time for me to wrap things up. But before that, I'd like to share a couple of rumors I found out there on the internet. For example, Darkstar will have a unique system called Prompt Global Strike. What is that? And this is a program that will be used specifically to attack literally any point on the planet. The Earth in just 1 hour. And it won't require any human involvement. You just need to specify the target, and that's it. Amazing, isn't it? So, what do you think of this aircraft? Share your thoughts about it in the comments. And I'll keep waiting, because this aircraft is supposed to come out by the end of this decade. I hope you enjoyed this video, and thank you for watching.